So hi friends, welcome to TP Chennai. So we will continue with your last year SBI clerical mains level examination questions, right? So this is one set of DI which they have asked, and it was purely based upon last year clerical mains 2020 memory based paper. So first let me read here what they have given you. There are three cubes ABC. These cubes are cut into three cube which is PQR. So initially you were having ABC cube. These three cubes ABC is cut into another cube PQR. So of course ABC side will be more, PQR side will be less. Now so three conditions they have given you, and based upon that they have asked you four questions. First one, side of cube P is calculated by x square minus 10x plus 25 is equal to 0, and difference between the side of cube P and cube A is 3 meter. Second one, side of cube Q is calculated by x square minus 4x minus 12 is equal to 0, and the difference between side of cube Q and cube B is 4 meter. Third one, side of cube R is calculated by x square minus 8x plus 16 is equal to 0, and difference between the side of cube R and cube C is 5 meter. Then they have asked you this first question. Difference between volume of cube A and B, purely based upon mensuration, right? So always I used to say that never leave any chapter when it comes to your examination. Mensuration is a formula based chapter, so those who knows formula, they can only able to solve this question. First you have to understand the concept what they have given. First condition, side of cube P is calculated by x square minus 10x plus 25 is equal to 0. So by this equation we have to calculate the side of P, which is nothing but the value of x, which is the value of P. So x square minus 10x plus 25 is equal to 0, it's nothing but this is x minus 5 whole square is equal to 0, so x will be 5. That means side P is 5, right? So I am writing it separately, P is 5, and difference between the side of cube P and A is 3 meter. That means A will be more, because from A only they have cut it into P, so A will be 3 more, that means A will be 8. Similarly, side of cube Q is calculated by x square minus 4x minus 12 is equal to 0. So solve this equation, that means your roots will be minus 6 and 2. Final value will be 6 and minus 2. Negative will not come. That means Q is nothing but 6. Q is nothing but 6. And B is 4 meter more. So B will be 10. Similarly, third condition. Side of cube R is calculated by x square minus 8x plus 16 is equal to 0. That means this is x minus 4 whole square is equal to 0. So x is equal to 4. That means R will be 4. R will be 4. And C is 5 more. That means C will be 9. That's it. Right? Now first question. Difference between the volume of cube A and B. What is volume of a cube? Side cube. A is nothing but 8, so 8 cube minus B is 10 cube. So 10 cube is 1000 and 8 cube is 512. 1000 minus 512, what is the answer? 488. Second option. Answer is second option. So now we'll see second question. Find the average of surface area of cube A, cube Q, cube R. What is the formula of surface area of a cube? 6 into side square, right? So cube A, side is 8. 8 square 64. 64 into 6, 384. All this would be your mind calculation. Even though you are solving main question, but your mind should run continuously. Cube Q, side Q is what? 6. 6 square 36. 36 into 6, 216. Plus cube R, side of R is 4, 4 square 16, 16 6 are 96, by 3, right? So this is 384, 6 plus 6, 12 plus 4, 16, 10, 11, 19, 4, 6, so 6, 96 by 3, what is the answer? 232 is the answer, which is nothing but second option. So now we'll see question number 3. Find the ratio between the surface area of cube Q and cube C. So ratio, that means 6 and 6 will be cancelled. Side cube Q, what is the value of side of cube? 6. 6 square is 36 is to C. Cube C, what is the side of C? 9. 9 square is 81. So 9 4 is 9, 9. The answer 4:9, which is nothing but first option. So now we'll see question number 4. Volume of cube B is what percent more than volume of cube P? So we know, we should know the formula of volume. So volume of cube is side cube. So B, what is the side here? 10. 10 cube is 1000. Right? And volume of cube P, side P is how much? 5. 5 cube is 125. Now they are asking volume of cube B is what percent more? That means we need to calculate the ratio first. So 125 ones are, 125 eights are. Right? So it is how much more? 7. 7 by P. P value is 1 into 100. What is the answer? 700% is the answer. Answer is nothing but 700%. So now we'll see second type of DI, which they have asked last year in SBI Clerical Mains 2020 mains examination. So they have given you cylinder. You have 5 different cylinders: cylinder A, cylinder B, cylinder C, cylinder D, cylinder E. Radius of each cylinder and height of each cylinder they have given you. And then they have asked 5 questions. First one, if some cubes of side 2 cm is filled in cylinder A and cylinder B, find the difference of number of cubes filled in both the cylinder. Right? Number of cubes filled in both the cylinder is nothing but volume of a cylinder divided by volume of a cube. And then we have to take the difference of those two values. So first A, we need to calculate first cylinder A and then cylinder B. What is the formula of volume of a cylinder? Pi r square h. So I am directly writing 22 by 7 r. Radius of cylinder A is 10 square A, right? This is 10 square. H is 14 divided by volume of a cube. Side of cube they have given you 2 cm. So it will be 8 minus 22 by 7. Radius of B is 49 and height is 20 divided by 8. Either you can take common or calculate individually and take the difference. So 7 2s are 2 4s are 425s are. So we need to multiply 22 into 25. 22 into 5 is 110, into 5 is 550 minus 7 7s are 4 2s are 4 5s are 2 11s are. 35 into 11 is 386. Subtract this number. So 500 will give you 586. Right? Minus this is 130. This is 385. Right? 35 into 11 is 385. So it is 165. My answer is 165, which is option. So now we see question number 2. If cylinder C is 40% filled with water and cylinder D is 80% filled with water, find the difference between the empty volume of both the cylinder. If cylinder C is filled with 40%, so empty will be 60%, and cylinder D is filled with 80%, so empty will be 20%. Right? So for 60%, what is fraction value? 3 by 5. Into volume of cylinder C, r square h. So r square h, cylinder C, what is the value? 196. H is 12. Right? Minus cylinder D, 80% filled, empty will be 20%. 1 by 5. 22 by 7 r square h 441, height is 9. Right, so from this I can take 22 by 5 common. Right, this is 7 7 2s are 14, 28 here. This is 7 6 are 42, 3 are, right? So then I can take even 22 also, 21 also common. So this will be how much? 48. And this will be how much? 7 9s are 27. right? So this is how much? 22.5 into 21 into this is 21. 21 square is 441. I am writing here. 21 square is 441. So we need to multiply here. So multiply this number 441 into 22, right? So first multiply this number 2's up and 44 into 22 is nothing but how much? 970 divided by 5, right? So this is 5, 19's are 95, this is 202 means 40 into 4. 1940.4 is the answer, which is nothing but first option. So now we see question number 3. Difference between diameter and height of cylinder A is what percent more or less than difference between diameter and height of cylinder C? So A, C. Radius of cylinder A is 10, diameter will be double 20, so 20 minus 14 is 6. And the diameter of and height of cylinder C, radius of cylinder C is 14, diameter is 28, 28 minus 12 is 16. So this is 2 3's are 2 8's are. It is how much more? 5. 5 by 8 into 100. 1 by 8, what is percentage value? 12.5. So 5 by 8 will be 62.5%. So my answer is nothing but second option. So now we will see question number 4. Find the ratio of curved surface area of cylinder E and B. What is the formula of curved surface area? 2 pi RH. So 2 pi will be cancelled. Just you have to take this is E and this is B. R into H, 12 into 21, and B 7 into 20. Right? This is 7 3's are 4 3's are 4. 5 is up. So my answer is 9 is to 5, which is nothing but third option. So now we will see question number 5. Find the sum of total surface area of cylinder B and E approximately. What is the formula of total surface area of cylinder? 2 pi r into h plus r. So this is B and this is E. So 2 pi r, 2 into 22 by 7, r is 7 into 27 plus 2 into 22 by 7 into E, 12 into 32, right? 12 into 32. So from this I can take this part as common, right? I can take this part as common. That means 44 by 7, I'm taking common, this is 189 plus. What is 32 into 12? 32 into 12 is nothing but 64 into 6, 384. Right? 64 into 6. So this is 44 by 7 into this is 9 into 4 is 13. 9 plus 4 is 13. 9 plus 8 is 17. And this is 3 plus 4 is 5. So 9 plus 4 is 13. Carry is 1, 9 plus 8 is 70, 3 plus 1 5, right? Now we have to multiply. When you multiply here, multiply this one. First multiply this one with 40. So this is 0, 4 is 12, 7 29, 7 20, 22, right? 22 plus this number, 4 3 is 12, 29, and this is 21, 2192. 2.92 and add 2.11.75 by 7. Approximately they are asking, right? So 7 3 is a 21, 47 5 is a, anything starts with there, right? 7 6 is a, sorry. So my answer is 3680. Approximately my answer is nothing but 3680, which is first option. So observe here, this is h plus r of E. 22 plus 12 plus 21 is 33, and this will be 33. So this will be how much? 66, 396 will come here, right? right? Here it will be 396. This is 396. Right, so when you multiply here, this will be 9 plus 6 15. So again I am doing here, this is 44 by 7 into 9 plus 6 is 15, 10, 18, 19, 9 plus 6 15 carries 1, 10, 18, this is 595. Right, so again when you multiply 595 here, so what you are going to get, this multiplies 595 into 40 plus 4, right, mind calculation only. 0, 5, 4, 20, 38, 23. Plus, this is how much? 5, 4, 20, 9, 12, 36, 2, 38, 3, 23. 0, 8, 11. Right? So, when you multiply here, you are going to get 3, 6, 7, 7, which is nothing but first option. So, I hope you have understood the concept very well. So, prepare well. All the best. Thanks a lot.